Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome to day 4 of App Store Domination, your 30 days challenge. And today we are going to talk about iTunes Connect. So let's get to work. Okay. Last time we took a look at the Apple Developer Portal and we made our signing certificates. I hope you did that so you can have a team in your Xcode project. Okay, now next up we are going to take a look at iTunes Connect. And for that, let us just open up here and let's go to developer.apple.com. And if you click on account and you are already signed in, go ahead and sign in if you haven't already done so, you can see that there is an iTunes Connect part of our account. So let's go ahead and tap on that. Let's go to iTunes Connect and let me just select my own iTunes Connect. A lot of clients iTunes Connect available. Now, welcome to iTunes Connect. And as you can see, if you do have something important to be made, then you will have an alert up here. And of course, we have some news from Apple, but the most important parts are here. My apps, app analytics, sales and trends, payments and financial reports, users and roles, agreements, tax and banking, and resources and help. Now, first thing you want to do is go into agreements, tax and banking and set up your tax info, banking info, and of course agree to all of the terms. Go ahead and create all of your contracts in there. I will not go into there, all of my contracts are up to date, but you need to take care of this first. So this is really a personal data, so I will not show you that now, but what I will do show you is my apps. And before we do that, let's talk, well, all of these app analytics, sales and trends, payments and financial reports, they are self-explanatory. And users and roles, it's quite highly advanced because you can set up your test users and we will not go through them. If you want to take a look at these, I do have a course on that and it is called the tribe. So go ahead and take a look at the tribe. If you go to rebeloper.com and you select the tribe, then you can take a look at all advanced sections of my course. Okay, now let's go back to iTunes Connect and let's select my apps. And here you need to create, well, an app for your project, because it is not, when you create it in Xcode, it's not an app, it's just a project. So to do that, and of course here you have all of your apps, and let me just go through, well, this one was rejected and it was because of a reason that my banner ahead was overlapping a button, so I need to fix that in a few days now. And here we have a prepare for submission, and that is what you will see most of the time when you are preparing your app, you are building your app, you are preparing it for submission. Now, once you submit it for review, it says waiting for review, like this one. And once it is approved, then it will say ready for sale. And as you can see, 2.0.0 is the version number of our app. And of course, you have the icon here, so you can easily find them. Of course, you can find, search and find any app you want here. Okay, now let's build a new app. So go ahead and click on this plus button and select new app. And it is highly important that you already made sure that in the developer portal, you have your bundle ID existing there, because you need to choose your bundle ID here. So I would first of all choose our platform. The name is the Magic. Of course, again, this is not the display name on iTunes, on the App Store. This is just an internal name. Okay, primary language is English. And the bundle ID, and of course I have a lot of here, but you will choose your set bundle ID. So let me just find mine. Okay, here it is. If you are doing this right after the previous lesson, then you might want to wait a few 10 minutes because it might not appear here. SKU is an internal, well, a number. Let's just type in here, Rebeloper 0.00, let's say 23. It doesn't really matter. Okay, let's create this. Okay, here we are. And once it loads, here we have our app inside iTunes Connect, and we have already some pre-filled things, and there are some things that we need to add later on. I will talk about this in a later video. For now, I will just guide you through all of these steps. Well, first of all, we have our app information, where we have our general information. Next up is our pricing and availability. Here you set your price for your app. Most probably you will set it for free and maybe have some in-app purchases or ads in it. Of course, if your app is live on the App Store, you can revoke it. Well, you can remove it from sale under this pricing and availability tab. Of course, next up is we have our first version. So here we have our prepare for submission. Let's just tap on that. And here you need to add all of your screenshots, promotional tags, description, keywords, and so on, your build. We will talk about this later on. So here you have your preview screenshots, app previews, your promotional tags, keywords. We will talk about this in a later episode. Now, let's go to features. Now, under features, you can set up your in-app purchases, maybe your App Store promotions, Game Center, if you have encryptions or promo codes. Now, under test flight, you can manage your test flight builds. Now, your build is, a zipped file uploaded to iTunes Connect. Well, we will upload builds later on from Xcode, and they will be shown under activity, because this is where your builds will be shown once they are processed by iTunes Connect. And that is all, essentially. That is all you need to know for now on iTunes Connect. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video. Go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't already done so, subscribe to the channel, and of course take a look at the Tribe. This is a more advanced version of App Store Domination, where you can get your hands on our 24 plus source codes and 40 plus action plans, where you can build your massive app business. So go ahead and take a look at that. And as usual, I will see you in the next one. Good stuff. Now, if you want to see more of this video and want to boost your app business, go ahead and take a look at my 30 days challenge, App Store Domination. Go ahead and click the link down below, and I will see you inside ASD, App Store Domination. Let's get to work.